So when you're working with data, one of the things that you need to be aware of is the quality of the data. So what you need to do is make sure that you assess the data on certain criteria to make sure that the quality is good. The first thing you should always check with the data is accuracy. Does the data represent the real world? Okay. Now, what I mean by this is, let's say you're collecting data on transactions. Okay. So you're collecting how much people are spending. What you want to make sure is that the data you see in there is represented in the real world. So if someone's buying products, okay, normally it should be positive values, right? So you've got, you know, someone buys an item for $9.99, in the transactions you should see $9.99. If suddenly you see minus values, you need to check if those minus values are real world values or something's happened in the data. Now, they may be real world values because you may find that people could do refunds and therefore the refunds are actually logged in the transaction as a minus number, but sometimes they're not. So you just need to make sure that if you see values that don't represent the real world, that you check to validate the accuracy of those numbers. So like I said, accuracy is very important when you're talking about data quality. Just make sure that the data you see in your tables, in your database, reflects what happens in the real world. The next thing you should check for in terms of data quality is completeness, okay? Because if you have incomplete data, then it's not going to reflect the real world either. So what I mean by completeness is that, let's take transactions and there's another example. What you don't want to be recording is missing every 10th transaction or missing random transactions, okay? You want to make sure that all transactions are recorded systematically and, you know, are complete. Even things like, for example, if you're measuring activity on your website, let's say you're measuring visitors, okay? You wanna make sure that you're systematically always collecting visitor data or always collecting page views. What you don't wanna do is the system randomly or even if there's a pattern missing data. So data completeness is very important for data quality. The next thing you wanna check for data quality is consistency. Now, what I mean here by consistency is that the data you're seeing from all different systems coming in, are they consistent, okay? So are you getting them all on a hourly basis, on a daily basis, on a weekly basis? What is the frequency in which you're getting that data, and make sure it's consistent? Because if you start reporting on data and some data is only 12 hours old and some data is actually 48 hours old, it's not going to work. Because if I look at yesterday's data, let's say for transactions and coupons, use of coupons, let's say the coupon data is 48 hours old, but the transaction data is only 12 hours old. So if I looked at yesterday, I would only be seeing transaction data and I'll be seeing zero data for coupon data because that's 48 hours old. I've got to wait 48 hours for yesterday's data to come in. So therefore, you've got to make sure that there's consistency so that when you look at your data, you're looking at the accurate numbers at the time that you want to look at them. So therefore, make sure all the data that you are getting into your system are consistent. Now, related to consistency is up-to-date, timeliness, okay? And what I mean by this is that I've worked in clients where, for example, transactional data is stored on a local POS in the retail store and then uploaded every 14 days or up to 14 days. So some stores were very good, they would upload them overnight. Some stores would actually wait until 14 days to upload them, okay? So it was just a service level agreement they had with the head office in when they'd upload data. If that's the case, then what you have is that you can't actually report on data until everybody's provided all their data. So make sure that you have timeliness in the data for what you need the business to do. Now, it may be fine to wait 14 days if you're not going to make decisions every day. If you're going to make decisions once a month or if you're going to make decisions once a quarter, then waiting 14 days for data to come is fine. But if you need to make decisions immediately, let's say you run a marketing campaign and you want to see if sales has gone up, then it's very important that the timeliness of the data is very recent. You can't wait 14 days for data to come in if you want to measure the impact of a marketing campaign that happened yesterday. And then the final thing you should look in data quality, which would probably be the most obvious thing, is the validity of the data. Okay, so if you're collecting transactional data, for example, then you're looking at actual numerical values, okay, so, you know, revenue numbers or monetary numbers, okay. If suddenly you start seeing text in those fields, then you should start questioning how valid that data set is, because it's containing values that you shouldn't see in there. Or if you start seeing very huge numbers that shouldn't be there, so for example, if you have a transactional system where you are a grocer, for example, you might get sales of £300, £400, £500, £600, but you wouldn't necessarily get transactions of £10,000, £20,000. Okay, so if you start seeing values of £10,000, £20,000, £30,000, £40,000, you need to ask yourself how valid the validity of the data source. So when we talk about data quality, those are the things that we're talking about. So you should be looking at things like the accuracy of the data, the completeness, the consistency, the timeliness, and the validity of the data. Okay, and once you're satisfied with that, then you can assume that your data is clean. Now, sometimes you won't get 100% on all of those, but you you need to, as a business or as an analyst, decide what is good enough, okay? And then use that basis or that criteria to move forward in terms of doing your analysis. Well, thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please do like and share the video and look out for future videos. Thank you.